Hi, and welcome back. In this video, we'll introduce you to the new record-level security feature of the Common Data Service. We've always supported environment, database, and entity-level security, as we showed you earlier. Now, we're adding record-level security as well. Record-level security, or RLS, allows administrators to define policies that determine what records in an entity a user can see. RLS is important for many customers that want to define the subset of records that a user should see in their database. As an example, sellers of flooring products should only see those products that are active, not those that are inactive, because you don't want to see what was available before or what's not yet available for customers. Policies specify a dimension and the allowed values on those dimensions. The first policies we're supporting are based off of ownership and pick list. Let's go take a look in the portal. In previous videos, we created user roles and permission sets, and now we're going to add the policies. Policies are added to a permission set and qualify the CRUD permission level allowed on an entity. In this case, I'm going to create a policy on the flooring product status. The policy type is picklist, and we're going to use the picklist status. Next, we select an operator, equals in this case, and we want them to only see the active flooring products. So we're going to select value active. Now we've now created this policy for flooring product status. We will then go back and associate it with the permission set we created in the previous video. We open up the flooring estimate permission set we previously created. If we scroll down to the flooring estimate, we can see that there is the create, read, update, and delete permissions we'd previously defined. But we want to make that better. We want to enhance that with the policy we just created. We're going to assign a policy. We're going to assign it for create, read, update, and delete. As you saw in previous videos, we have a status field in our flooring estimate. And to that field, we're going to apply the flooring product status policy. You recall, that was when it was active. Creating assigned policy has now added these four permissions to that policy, and we save. If we go back out and scroll back down, we now see that each of the create, read, update, and delete permission levels are annotated with the letter P, indicating a policy has been associated with that permission set. In the future, we are adding support for other types of policies. We right now have owner and pick list. We will soon support hierarchies, business units, and other more complex business concepts in the near future as well.